And so we've heard of people making all kinds of discoveries at the beach, like class rings, wedding rings, or even messages in bottles. But this mysterious discovery along Diamond Head Beach will have you scratching your head and wondering how and even why it's here. Tammy Mori has a story you'll only see on KHON2. Tammy.
Marissa, a surfer was walking along the beach when she found an urn along the shoreline. And it's not just any urn, it's sealed and marked with a name on it. And it's now her mission to make sure the woman gets a proper burial. Heather Faustin has been holding on to this urn since January when she discovered it near some rocks off of Black Point.
I went over to it and I picked it up, and then I saw that it had like someone's name on it, and then it was someone's ashes.
And the urn is sealed off at the top, like it's never been opened.
Yeah, it's totally intact. It's in like a plastic container, and you can, when I shake it, you can totally tell there's something in it. I just feel like if I opened it, I'd be tampering with it and just not respectful.
Now she's on a mission to make sure it gets a proper burial.
You know, it was a little weird, but I just knew that I couldn't just leave it there. So my first reaction was to find the family.
And on the urn are some hints to where it came from. The name on the box reads Betty Rhea Hilton Hopman and says she is from Marina Del Rey, California.
I was able to get a phone number, but it was disconnected. So then I called her apartment that she lived in, and another dead end. They really didn't know where to direct me.
After searching for 6 months, she decided to go public, hoping to get more answers. We asked boat captains who are accustomed with burials at sea, and even they thought it was an unusual find.
So generally what we do is we sail off Waikiki out far enough to scatter ashes. Seldom do we drop an urn.
For now, there are more questions than answers.
That is a mystery. I have no idea how that could possibly be. And I hope that they do connect and that they find out and lay to rest the person properly.
For me, like, if it was my grandma, I couldn't just, you know, not know. I would want to know. So I would hope that someone would contact me and let me know.
And we, too, are helping Faustin with her search. If she isn't able to make contact with the family soon, she plans to scatter the ashes herself to make sure the woman is properly laid to rest. Tammy Mori, KHON2 News.